نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ فرقنا بكم البحر فأنجيناكم وأغرقنا آل فرعون وأنتم تنظرون رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي رب زدني علما آمين Indeed, all praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek His help and His forgiveness. And then I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His peace and blessings upon all the prophets and especially the last and the noble prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the followers of the deen of Islam. Ameen. My dear brothers in Islam, I have recited an ayat from Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, ayat number 50. In which Allah mentions and recall, He is addressing Qawme Bani Israel, that is the companions of Musa alayhi salam. He mentions and recall when we parted the sea for you and saved you and drowned the people of Firaun while you were looking on. So please concentrate on the meaning of this ayat. Subhanallah, there are so many points in this. Even you have some psychological issues, Alhamdulillah. The very first point is, Allah has parted the sea, which itself is a huge miracle. Allah commands Musa alayhi salam to hit the sea water with his staff, with his asa. And the sea gives the way to the companions of Musa alayhi salam. Alhamdulillah, that's a huge miracle. That is point number one. And point number two is, Allah mentions, and recall when we parted the sea for you and saved you. Allah has saved from the tyrant ruler Firaun and his associates by parting the sea and giving a way to the companions of Musa alayhi salam. Allah has saved them from their enemies, that is Firaun and his associates. Then I repeat, and recall when we parted the sea for you and saved you and drowned the people of Firaun while you were looking on. And look at the next point here. Allah has made the people of Firaun along with the Firaun to get drowned in the same sea while Musa alayhi salam and his companions were looking on. Subhanallah. Sometimes it so happens that you have an enemy in your life. And he is very strong, very powerful. He has political influence. He has huge wealth. And he has huge number of followers. All that which makes him powerful, strong. And if such a person becomes your enemy and Allah saves you once, Alhamdulillah. But still, what happens? If you are saved from him once and after that you don't know what happened to your enemy, whether he is alive or not, then you will have your own doubts. You will have your own fears. You might be worried about the next attack. You might be thinking that the enemy will be attacking you some other day from some unknown corner to you. Isn't it? From any corner he may attack and anything may happen to you, your family, so on and so forth. You will be left to your own guesswork, assumptions, doubts and fears. But in this case, Allah gave relief to Musa alayhi salam and his companions. It's not just protecting them after protecting them, after saving them from their enemy and his associates. Allah gave complete relief to Musa alayhi salam and his companions by making Musa alayhi salam and his companions look at the situation of their enemies who got drowned in the same waters. Subhanallah. Allah has put Fir'aun and his associates to utter humiliation, because Fir'aun was such a tyrant ruler that he claimed divinity also. He used to say that he himself is the God and there is no other God other than himself. Na'uzu billah. Such a tyrant ruler, such a powerful ruler, he got drowned along with his associates in the water and they were put to death. Subhanallah. That was an utter humiliation on one hand, and it was a source of great relief for Musa alayhi salam and his companions, because they were made to see that with their own eyes. Allah mentions, and drowned the people of Fir'aun while you were looking on. And these people, you know, alhamdulillah, they had two great personalities to guide them. Two great personalities, two prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them, and they are Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun alayhi salam. So alhamdulillah, this ayat has so many things for us to remember, understand. Alhamdulillah, may Allah grant us understanding. May Allah forgive all of our sins. May Allah protect us from the evil clutches of the haters of Islam, the enemies of Islam. And may Allah grant understanding to them also. May Allah turn the hearts of the haters of Islam towards Islam and make them our brothers in the deen of Islam. Ameen. And may Allah unite all of us in Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.